will be informed by their individual needs and need to make sure that their requirements are fully met. To this end, the government requires that a test is undertaken to determine whether any proposal put forward is as good as or better than the children's current provision. In order to do this and make sure to focus on each child's individual and unique needs, meetings have been held at the school involving each child's parents where they wish to attend, the school and any other key professionals to make sure that we have a fully up-to-date understanding of each child's needs. We are undertaking this consultation in the context of Wirral having exceptionally high quality provision for children with complex learning difficulties. Council's responsibility is to ensure that there are sufficient school places and that with the support and oversight of the school's forum, school's grant funding is allocated appropriately. Regarding consultation process, Cabinet and the coordinating committee called in the original decision to begin the consultation made it very clear from the outset that the process should be open and transparent. I will now set out some of the actions taken during the 12-week period of consultation from the 2nd of April until the 25th of June. Immediately prior to the consultation starting, there was a meeting with the parent governors of the Lindale School to get them through the consultation process. There have been six public consultation meetings in venues across the whole of Wirral. 85 parents and community members attended the meetings. We were happy for people to come to more than one meeting, which indeed this is what people did. The council has commissioned an independent person to consider each of the published proposals and any new options that have emerged during the consultation period. This person will also consider the application of the government test about suitability of all the options, that is, the SEN improvement test. Can I also say, meetings have been held with the staff of the three special primary schools, Stanley, Ellery Park and the Lindale School. Council's human resources managers have also facilitated a meeting with the staff of the Lindale School and a future meeting scheduled this week. All elected members were invited on an escorted bus tour to visit each of the three primary schools for children with complex learning difficulties, including the Lindale School and the two secondary schools. 22 elected members took part in these visits on the 16th and 17th of June. In conclusion, I can assure all members of the council that all the information relevant to the consultation will be made publicly available prior to the meeting of the Cabinet to inform a decision making on the 4th of September. I would also like to assure this Council that by taking all factors into account to determine the way forward, the needs and welfare of each individual child is essential to our decision making. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Let us remember, actually, the way Tony speaks about this and see how it was done. It just came up. So, okay. This is a third option put forward by the council about closing Lindale School. And that's why it was called in. It wasn't some sort of offer from the cabinet to say, why don't you as a scrutiny committee have a look at this and do the right thing? It was a decision was taken that had to be called in. Now it seems to me, Mr. Mayor, that Councillors Hayes, Gilchrist, Mitchell, Colson and have dealt effectively with pretty well. But every item that needed dealing with, it's not going to stop me making other remarks, I clearly will. And could I savings to be made from closing the Lindale School rather than money being redistributed around the school system. And again, we have this view that's allowed to change the school. All we have to do is to make sure we are giving the right amount per pupil, the proper cost per pupil in that school. And that is the issue. And to suggest that somehow it's different than that, again, Mr. Mayor is disingenuous. Over 10,000 people have signed a petition to keep Lindale School open. That figure is more than the number of respondents in any of the consultations the council has annually run since 2010, indicating public support to retain the Lindale. Mr. Mayor, it's clear to me that should the Lindale School close, the expectation is that children will transfer to either Ellery Park or Stanley School. Both in their own way, excellent and outstanding schools. Parents of all three schools have expressed concern over this because the needs of the children in these schools are so very different in many cases. Mr. Mayor, the point that was raised by Paul. In January 2011, following a review of primary school places and the associated consultation, council officers recommended the closure of Kingsway Primary School in Seaford. It was a small school like Lindale School. At its meeting on the 3rd of February 2011, a proposal was put forward by Conservative members, as it happens, of the Cabinet to keep the school open, and it has stayed open and thrived. The school's most recent Ofsted inspection was outstanding. It would appear, Mr. Mayor, that officers were incorrect in recommending the closure in the case of Kingsway, and I submit they're incorrect in proposing the closure of the Lindale School now. And I would call, even at this late stage, for the administration to have a change of heart and consider retaining Lindale School as an open facility doing outstanding jobs for children, parents and parents.
Previously, consultation processes have been expedited. The leader of the council himself has spoken of an early evaluation of the consultation. So then why is it, Mr. Mayor, that we need to wait until the 4th of September before the consultation, which ended on the 25th of June, can be fully divulged to the public and fully debated? The fact is, this council, in debating this notice of motion this evening, is taking a view and making a recommendation to Cabinet, as it has done so many times on previous occasions on different issues. Now, I will make one small observation, and that is on the consultation process. It seems to me that both the leader of the council and Councillor Smith, the cabinet member, has spoken of this consultation process in glowing terms. It's been held out as some sort of example of good practice, and it's been spoken of in exemplary terms from both Councillor Davis and Councillor Smith. The fact is, it's not exemplary at all. Answers, questions that were put to councillor officers in March were answered on the final day of that consultation. Where is the equality of arms in that? Where's the fairness in that? The fact is, there is none. The consultation process itself was flawed. It's time to end the misery and the pain that we are making the children and staff endure, and it's time to make for the cabinet to make a resolution that this school remains open. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Okay, the voting on the amendment was 35-4, 26 against and 1 abstention. So therefore the amendments have been carried. I'm not aware of the other amendments that have been moved. So is it agreed that we move to a vote on the substantive motion as amended?
Can't vote, please, Mr. Mayor.
Do we have to have a card vote? Yeah. Okay, card vote has been called. Okay. My members stand up. Special cabinets as arranged.